Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 6.2. The topic is viscous fluid flow. So, in the earlier lecture also we discussed the viscous fluid flow or laminar fluid flow. We continue with the discussion. So, in the previous lecture, we discussed about the, we introduced the viscous fluid flow, Reynolds number, we defined the Reynolds number and the laminar flow through the circular pipe and laminar flow between parallel plates we have discussed. And in this lecture, we are going to talk about Cauchy flow and the power loss due to viscous resistance in journal bearing, footstep bearing and collar bearing. The learning outcome to the students, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the Cauchy flow and calculate the power loss due to viscous resistance in journal bearing, footstep bearing and the collar bearing. And maybe in the next lecture, we will be solving problem for calculating the power loss due to viscous resistance in journal bearing, footstep bearing and the collar bearing. And the Cauchy flow. When the flow between two parallel plates, so we have discussed the earlier lecture, the flow between two parallel plates where both the plates are fixed. But here in the flow between two parallel plates, when one plate is fixed and another plate is moving, the flow is called as Cauchy flow. The flow of lubricating oil in narrow space between journal and the bearing is identical with the Cauchy flow with the pressure gradient. So normally in the journal bearing, the rotating, there will be a rotating shaft and the fixed journal. So, there will be small quantity of the fluid in between for lubrication, oil in between. So, the flow of the lubricant between the rotating shaft and the fixed journal, it is called as the Cauchy flow. So, look at the arrangement. So, you have a plate which is fixed at the stationary plate and you have another plate at the top at a distance T from the base plate. And this plate is moving with the velocity capital U. And this is the velocity distribution, velocity profile for the Cauchy flow. And we consider the fluid element of thickness delta X and delta Y. So, delta Y is the thickness in the Y direction and delta X is the thickness in the X direction. And in the Z direction, delta Z, which is considered as 1. Now, here the pressure force acting here. So, P into dy because delta z equal to 1, P into dy and the pressure force acting on the opposite side equal to P plus dou P by dou x into dy and the shear stress force acting in the bottom surface is, it is in the opposite direction, tau into dx into dz, dz equal to 1 and in the opposite top surface the shear force equal to tau into dou tau by dou y into dy into dx. So, these are all the forces acting on the fluid element, the two pressure forces and two forces due to the shear stress and the bottom and the top surfaces. Now, the forces acting on the fluid element are pressure force acting on the face AB, so P into delta Y into delta Z, where delta Z equal to 1. Pressure force acting on the face CD, P plus dou P by dou x into delta Y into delta Z, so delta Z equal to 1. The shear force acting on the base BC, tau into delta X into delta Z and the shear force acting on the face AD, tau into dou tau by dou Y into delta X delta Z. Then for steady and uniform flow, the sum of the forces in the direction of the flow equal to 0. So, we substitute the pressure force P plus P into delta Y delta S minus P into P plus dou P by dou X into delta Y delta Z. And then the shear stress, the force due to the shear stress minus tau into delta X delta Z plus tau into dou tau by dou Y into delta X delta Y equal to 0. We expand the terms. So, first term as it is, second term they are expanded. So, minus P into delta Y delta Z minus dou P by dou X into delta Y delta Z. The third, this term is as it is and here it is expanded tau into delta X delta Y and plus dou tau by dou Y into delta X delta Y delta Z. Now, the first term and the second term, they are getting cancelled. They are equal and opposite direction. and here shear stress term, again these two are equivalent in opposite direction, they are getting cancelled. So finally, it is left out minus dou p by dou x into delta x delta y delta s delta z plus dou tau by dou y delta x delta y delta z equal to 0. Here again delta x delta y delta z common term and is getting deleted. So minus dou p by dou x equal to dou tau by dou y. So this is the equation, final equation. The change in the shear stress with respect to y, the direction y direction is equal to the pressure gradient dou p by dou x. Now substituting the value of shear stress from the Newton's law of viscosity. So Newton's law of viscosity is shear stress equal to mu into dou u by dou y. So mu dou by dou y of mu into dou u by dou y equal to dou p by dou x. So this becomes dou square u by dou y square equal to 1 by mu dou p by dou x. So this is the equation. So now we have to integrate this equation to find the velocity distribution. So integrating the equation with respect to y, we'll get dou u by dou y equal to 1 by mu dou p by dou x into y plus c1. Integrating again, you will get u equal to 1 by mu dou p by dou x into y square by 2 plus c1y plus c2. Now in this velocity distribution equation, we have two constants c1 and c2. To determine the value of two constants, we require two boundary conditions. So from the definition of the problem, we define the boundary conditions at y equal to 0, that is the base plate. Velocity u equal to 0, there is no change in the fluid is not moving. At the y equal to t, at the top surface, the fluid is moving along with the plate is moving with velocity u, so u equal to capital U. So there are two parameters, y equal to 0, u equal to 0, y equal to t, the thickness, the gap between the two plates, u equal to capital U. Now the value of the constant c2 equal to 0 and c1 equal to u by t minus 1 by 2 mu into dou p by dou x into t. Now you can substitute the value of c1 in the equation number 14 and we'll get the substitute in the value of constant in the equation number 14 and the velocity distribution for the Cauchy flow becomes u equal to u by t into y minus 1 by 2 mu dou p by dou x into t y minus y square equal to that is the equation number 15. Now the shear stress is given by tau equal to mu into dou u by dou y. And substituting the value, so shear stress becomes mu into dou by dou y of this entire equation. So differentiating tau equal to mu into u by t minus 1 by 2 mu dou p by dou x into t minus 2y. So the equation shear stress equal to mu into u by t minus 1 by 2 dou p by dou x t minus 2y or mu into u by t into dou p by dou x t by 2 minus y. So this is the shear stress in the plate. Now we calculate the shear stress at different values of y. So the shear stress equal to t tau o at y equal to 0, which is substituting y equal to 0 here. This becomes mu into u by t minus dou p by dou x into t by 2. And when you substitute y equal to t by 2 and the shear stress become mu into u by t. And when you substitute y equal to t by 2 minus mu u by, actually we can put it another way. Shear stress will be equal to 0 when y equal to t by 2 minus mu u divided by t into dou p by dou x. At y equal to t, so mu equal to, the shear stress equal to mu into u by t plus dou p by dou x into t by 2. So these are all the value of shear stress at different points for the Cauchy flow. Then the power loss due to the viscous resistance in the journal bearing. So this is the journal bearing. Normally in all the mechanical equipment, rotating equipment, you will have the journal bearing. There is a shaft which is rotating with a constant speed and this is the journal. So this is the stationary element and in between we have a very thin layer of lubricating oil of a thickness T. When the shaft is rotating, so the layer of the layer of the oil along with the shaft is rotating and fluid layer with the journal is not moving. Now the torque required to overcome the viscous resistance T equal to viscous resistance into D by 2. So T equal to mu pi square D cube NL divided by 120 into T. So there is a derivation. So the derivation it is not required here, but if you want the derivation you can refer to the fluid mechanics book, you will get the derivation, but you have to remember this equation, the torque required to overcome the viscous resistance. So once you know the torque, we can calculate the power, absorbed to overcome the viscous resistance, P equal to 2 pi nt by 60, that is equal to substituting for torque from the previous equation. So mu into pi cube d cube n square l divided by 60 into 60 into t. So that you have to remember. Then the power loss due to the viscous resistance for footstep bearing. And this is a footstep bearing where we have the vertical shaft which is rotating and this element is stationary. And here again you may find a thin layer of oil between the shaft, rotating shaft, and the fixed footstep bearing. And here the torque required to torque and the power absorbed to overcome the viscous resistance, torque equal to 60 by mu by 60 into t into pi square n r to the power 4, where r is the radius, n is the speed, and t is the thickness of the oil film, and mu is the absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity of the oil. And the power equal to 2 pi nt by 60 once again. This is mu into pi cube n square r to the power 4 divided by 1800 into t. This is in watts. So, where n is the speed of the shaft in rpm and r is the radius of the shaft and t is the thickness of the oil film. And the power loss due to the viscous resistance for the collar bearing. So, this is the collar bearing where you have a collar fitted to the shaft and there is a oil film. So, between the stationary element and then the rotating collar and the shaft. So, here we have R1, R2. So, the R1 is the radius of the shaft and R2 is the outer radius of the collar and we have thickness of the film of thickness T. And again, that power and the torque, and the power absorbed to overcome the viscous resistance given by torque equal to mu by 60 into T into pi square N into R2 to the power 4 minus R1 to the power 4 in Newton meter and the power equal to mu by 1800 into t into pi cube n square into r2 to the power 4 minus r1 to the power 4 in watts. So, again where the n is the speed of the shaft in rpm, r1 is the inner radius of the collar or r2 is the outer radius of the collar and t is the thickness of the oil film. And these equations for calculating power and torque that you ought to remember for solving some numerical example and the Cauchy flow also we ought to remember the equations to calculate the shear stress at different points of y. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subjects. So, design of transmission system, turbo emissions, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. And this book you can refer for further discussion, further theory part and the problems in the viscous fluid flow. And I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject mentioned here. You can subscribe the YouTube channel. You use the videos for your better learning and to pass in the GATE examination. So, thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box of the YouTube video. You subscribe the channel and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. So, we'll meet again in another video lecture in the subject fluid mechanics and machines.